I want to begin by giving thanks for the opportunity to do this incredible work with the kids. It's really an honor. We have been doing an incredible program for the last few months that we've been able to offer for the fourth graders as a result of our partnership with the Center for Creative Education. The center is one of the best organized and most on-target arts organizations in the country as it relates to arts integration programs. The program that we've been running is called LEAP, and that means Learning Through Education and Arts Partnership. So what that means is that amazing artists come into the classroom and for a couple of months work with the teachers and the students to learn academic material. So what we were doing this year was a science unit, and so we got to move, and we got to create clay and visual dioramas and tell stories. And you know, the thing that is so amazing about this kind of program is that, you know, we all know that people learn differently. And we're all used to learning by reading and writing and talking about things. But in the arts integration program, we get to use all of the other senses and all the other facets of our minds that are creative and inspiring. So as they were learning about the science material, they got to do it by moving their bodies and creating clay and or shapes and creations with physical materials, or by creating characters to tell a story. And I can't tell you how much the kids really enjoyed this. Every morning I would come in and they asked, "Miss Ronnie coming today? Miss Joanne gonna be here?" And so they really loved it. The last thing I wanna say is that all of what you're going to see here today is original art. The students created every piece of it, every word. They did the research, they were asked the questions, and found out what they needed to learn, and then they wrote the stories. They created the movements. These aren't dances that were choreographed by a professional dancer and that they learned them, or fairy tales, folk tales that they are expressing. They wrote all of it. And so it's really an extraordinary piece of work you're about to see. So, we're going to start with Mrs. Clark's homeroom, and so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Annika Karpstein.
Hi, my name is Wilson Stewart.
Hi, my name is Addie Vining. Our group is studying solar energy.
Before we start sharing facts, let's talk about how we made this project.
We started by smearing clay over the base of a box to form grass.
We next made and painted the house. Around the same time, we made and glued the pool in.
Then, we added in the solar panels. We made the heads of the solar panels using mirrors.
Finally, we made the little animals sitting under the solar panels out of several colors of clay.
Did you know it takes less than 10 minutes for the sun's energy to travel from sun to earth?
Solar energy is one way of getting energy.
It captures the sun's rays and turns them into energy.
This energy source is among the best because it isn't harmful for the environment.
But it takes up land and causes habitat loss because it needs a lot of solar panels to produce enough energy for the things that depend on it.
They also cost a lot of money. I think our goals for the future should be lowering the cost so more people can use it.
On the other hand, it's a clean energy source, so it doesn't produce greenhouse gases. Greenhouse gases cause global warming, making our ice caps melt.
This house is run on solar energy, of course, but doesn't use many panels because it's not many square feet.
schools also run on solar energy. Of course, not as much as the house.
The animals are near the solar panels. This shows that solar energy is a very clean energy source.
This is one of the ways to reduce our carbon footprint, which is how we impact the Earth.
Did you know 40% of houses in 2015 use solar energy?
I hope you enjoyed our presentation. Have a nice day.
Hi, I'm Amy Chandler.
Hi, I'm Will McDonough.
We are studying nuclear energy. Nuclear power is the use of nuclear reactions that release nuclear energy to generate heat.
Before we get started into facts, we're going to tell you how we made this work of art. It started out as a cardboard box and clay. We decided that we could do more than that. We had paper mache for the grass, and we stuck clay for the sky.
Then we put the gray clay over some bottles to symbolize the nuclear power plants.
We put an earth on in the sky to symbolize the earth, a lake with a turtle in it to symbolize the animals, and people working on it on the power plants to symbolize the humans.
After that, our project was complete.
Now we are going to tell you the impacts. The nuclear energy impact on the earth is negative but can be positive. Nuclear power plants do not emit carbon dioxide during the operation, which is good. The high amounts of carbon dioxide are emitted in activities related to building and running the plants.
The nuclear energy impact on animals is also negative, especially for the aquatic animals and their habitats, which are quickly harmed by the operation.
The nuclear energy impact on humans is negative and positive. It is positive because it gives us electricity, and it is negative because the plants are harder to maintain.
Those are the impacts of nuclear energy.
To top it all off, we have a did you know for you.
Did you know that every 18 to 24 months, a power plant must be shut down to remove its spent uranium fuel, which becomes radioactive waste?
We hope you all enjoyed our presentation on nuclear energy. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Hadley.
And I'm Krish.
We are here to talk about fossil fuels. To start you off, we have some facts and goals to review before our presentation of this project.
What are fossil fuels? Fossil fuels are a neutral fuel such as coal or oil. It is formed in the geological past from the remains of living organisms.
Fossil fuels are found at the depths of Earth's surface and also the ocean surface. At first, our project was just plain with paper, toilet paper rolls to cover up, and pictures to collage down in this box. But then we realized that we should work harder than that we should get facts, build them up in our heads, and place it down. And after some very non-succeeding times, we finally came to a success.
Hadley and I also realized that maybe we should focus on the main idea of this project, the smokestacks that develop fossil fuel energy. But we really didn't have to do a lot to those, so we figured maybe we can add some extra items to it or around it. So we started covering beads with clay to make coal, which is also a fossil fuel, and we were a huge success with that also.
In the middle of this masterpiece, we have the smokestacks. This is the main idea of the project, and I hope you enjoy the things we have to share about them.
The smokestacks displayed here represent the impact on animals because of the fossil fuels that come out. How? Because it destroys animals' habitats. But don't worry, many still survive.
The brown mixed clay as our bottom is brown because if there once was grass, the fuel that comes out of the smokestacks would kill it, and it turns moldy brown.
Then we also have the ocean surface to the left of the fossil fuel tubes. That is there to show that fossil fuels aren't just around in the depths of the Earth's surface. They're also found on the ocean surface. The yellow clay behind it is a sunset setting behind the ocean blue.
Also, we have some oil marks in the ocean to show that oil is one of the main fossil fuels.
The oil rig in the background is there to show that it's one of the fossil fuel smokestacks and to show how they make oil, since oil is a fossil fuel.
On the outside of the box, we have some pictures to represent some of the fossil fuels, what they do, and some pictures of Earth to show that fossil fuel makes a big impact on Earth. We have a few more slides to share with you before we end our presentation. We have finally come to an end. I hope you enjoyed our presentation.
Thank you for your respectfulness and have a good day.
My name is Matthew Brodner.
My name is Asia Cohen.
And my name is J. Paul Jacobs.
And this is our geothermal energy project. Asia, what is geothermal energy?
Well, Matthew, good question. Geothermal energy is clean and sustainable heat from the earth. Geothermal energy can be found almost anywhere, from hot rock to hot water to soil in your own backyard.
That's very interesting, Asia. What do you know about geothermal energy, J. Paul?
I know that geothermal energy provides energy without using non-renewable resources, which means it reduces our carbon footprint.
Oh, it sounds like using this type of energy helps save the Earth's natural resources. Wait, that's awesome, but J. Paul, what is a carbon footprint?
A carbon footprint is defined as the total amount of greenhouse gases produced to directly and indirectly support human activities, usually expressed in equivalent tons of carbon dioxide.
Wow, it sounds like using this type of energy helps save the Earth's natural resources.
It does, but geothermal energy power plants are sometimes responsible for polluting the air and our waters, which can affect both humans and animals.
But Asia, the good thing is the geothermal energy will never run out. It will never expire, and it is found everywhere.
Oh, well, that's good. Now Matthew is going to share a fun fact with you guys.
Thanks, Asia. Humans have been enjoying geothermal energy in the form of hot springs for thousands of years.
So before we wrap things up, we will tell you about the details in our project.
So in our project, the gray toilet paper rolls with cotton balls on them are supposed to be where the smoke comes out and makes geothermal energy.
As you can see, the white tube was made from a plastic tube and another toilet paper roll. What it does is makes the water, and it takes the water and sucks up all the water. Inside the tube, it starts doing something to make into smoke.
Last but not least, the blue tissue paper on the bottom of the box is the water. And as told, the water is used to make smoke. I hope you guys are more interested in geothermal energy.
Please try to build a geothermal energy project at home. It's a very fun project.
Thank you for listening.
My name is Ellie, and our type of energy is wind power. What is that, you ask? It is a source of energy made by wind. It is harvested by the wind turbines and then turned into energy. Did you know that it is the fastest growing energy source?
Hi, my name is Evan. The impact on animals is that it changes wind patterns so birds can't fly straightly because the blades rotate and curl the wind around, and it takes up habitat space. Wind turbines have been used since 2000 BC.
Hi, my name is Sophia. The impact on Earth is that it reduces carbon, which is good. A wind turbine power plant works the same way as a fossil fuel power plant. They both use gas to power a wheel that turns an axle that powers homes. A single turbine can power 500 homes. Our project started as a roll of green tissue paper, a tennis ball, and a cup. We work to make it turn into what we imagined.
The impact on humans is very good. It's a renewable energy source. That means we will never run out of wind power. We made the wind turbine out of model magic clay and bundled sticks.
Some everyday ways to reduce our carbon footprint are
to use solar, hydroelectric, geothermal, nuclear, and wind energy products.
The blades of a wind turbine are attached to a shaft which only turns about 18 RPMs, and that is not nearly fast enough to generate electricity by itself. So the rotor shaft spins a series of gears that increase the rotation to about 1,800 RPM, and at that speed, the generator can produce a lot of electricity.
I hope you have learned something new about wind turbines.
Have a nice day.
We have a question for you. What is a hydroelectric water turbine? Well, if you don't know already, you're going to find out.
Hydroelectric energy works by using water turbines for energy.
When the water flows, it moves the turbine counterclockwise, which can generate energy for a house near water.
However, it can hurt fish. The water turbine can change the flow of the water and the temperature of the water too, and that can harm the fish eggs.
Also, by using hydroelectric energy, it can harm Earth. The greenhouse gas methane is released when the water turbine is on, hurting the air.
It also has a bad impact on humans. Hydroelectric energy makes humans move to a different area just because of the area being near the water.
There are no ways to conserve and reduce our carbon footprints by using hydroelectric energy.
Dams can also generate energy. The flow of the water creates energy, which goes into a different kind of turbine, and the turbine creates energy.
One more thing. There cannot be a speech without a bonus surprise. But we decided to do this fact on dams rather than turbines.
Devices at dams can help fish and other wildlife move freely around dams and between sections of rivers.
Fish ladders and fish elevators are just some of the techniques used to help fish migrate.
Fish ladders go upward around the dams and into the water to help the fish swim freely.
The fish jump up the ladders to get to the other side of the dam. Thank you for watching.
Well, I want to introduce one of our marvelous artists. This is Joanne Preston. She is a dance movement instructor that I've had the opportunity to work with for several years, and the kids love her. She's had so much fun with them, gotten them to do things they probably couldn't never have imagined that they could do. So this is Joanne.
Thank you so much. I'm so grateful to have had this opportunity to be at the Benjamin School. It's such a beautiful, supportive, nurturing, wonderful everything of the staff, the children. And yes, these children have really dug deep. They've moved in ways they didn't even know they could move. And they've done so many beautiful things with their words and their movements together in this science curriculum. And I'm so very proud of them and grateful. Thank you.
We're going to take that one from the top again.
doing?
Mining.
What?
I'm mining coal.
Stop mining coal.
Yeah, coal takes a long time to be produced and it's bad for the environment. This is a bad way to fuel the Earth, but scientists are finding a way to fuse other things like solar power energy, hydroelectric fuel, wind power, and biofuels. Biofuels replace gasoline.
Oil drill. Dirty, tall, fast moving, disturbing, drilling, black animals, big money, thick liquid, cars, slowly, spreading. Heating. Black. Toxic. Oil. Oil drill by Charlie Noble.
Non-renewable resources. Black. Hard. Mining, burning, melting, coal, ore, natural gas, oil, burning, drilling. Mining, solid, liquidy, fossil fuel, non-renewable resources by Taylor Kelly.
Fish by Zachary and Logan Smith. Fish, careful, selfish, fishing, watching, helping, snapper, dolphin, spinning, tuna, uncaring, overfishing, under. Fishing. Respectful. Terrible. Bait.
Animals by Jace Malamala. Overhunting is a problem. Sustainable harvesting is the key Stop tearing down those trees. Let our animals live free.
Ocean, the shimmering, shining ocean, yet beautiful, but in danger of us. To save them, we need to help them. If you think of a world without an ocean, there is no world, because there is no ocean. Ocean by Katie Tieford. Wishing, save them, help them, preserve them, love them, watching, absorbing, growing, large, larger reefs by Hannah Beam.
Water Cycle by Natalie Kona. Water Cycle. Blue. Sparkly. Swaying. Splashing. Freezing. Ocean. Beauty. Helping. Gorgeous. Burning. pouring, flowing, salty world. Water Cycle by Natalie Kona. Hydroelectricity by Parker McCollum. Hydroelectricity, electricity flashing, running, walking, splashing, water hitting, crashing, jumping, fast, faster, fastest, slow, slower, slowest. Hydroelectricity. Hydroelectricity by Parker McCollum. Charging water, running across a river. Bam! Running water, changing its speed, turning into a source of power. Hydroelectricity. This is a renewable resource. We will now survive. Hydroelectricity by Parker. Hibiscus by Emma Nordland. Hibiscus, beautiful, gorgeous, swinging, renewing, shimmering, forest, jungle, grasses, islands, growing, sprouting, twirling, bright, colorful, sun, air, water, flowers by Emma Nordland. Yeah. Trees by Grayson Murphy. Trees, tall, hard, swaying, growing, giving, forests, beaches, islands, mountains, raining, snowing, shining, peaceful, fruitful, renewable resources by Grayson Murphy. Flowers by Bryn Weiser. Flowers, blue, pink, swaying, renewing, sparkling. Pollen, bees, honey, shapes. Sprouting, shooting up, growing. Purple, orange. Flowers by Bryn Weiser.
Smith, and our resource is geothermal energy. And geothermal energy is earth heat. It is the temperature of the climate.
Whoa, that's hot.
Hi, my name is Joel Gelman, and geothermal energy has many uses.
Hello, my name is Robbie Rodman.
Geothermal energy can have good and bad consequences. A good consequence is that when you build a geothermal system for your house, or any building, the system doesn't get the heating and cooling mechanically, but it gets it from Earth's heat and cool.
The system has pipes that can go in the ground like a well, vertically or horizontally.
Geothermal energy is a resource that is usually used for heating and cooling. You use it to put the temperature to the degrees that you want.
Geothermal energy can also let out toxic fumes that can hurt humans and animals, but very rarely. It's not usual for it to happen.
Geothermal energy is found in the core of the Earth.
It costs a lot of money to make a geothermal energy plant. They have to use this geothermal energy plant to get geothermal energy from the core of the Earth to help us change the temperature, like if you're using a thermometer.
Geothermal energy is mostly used in the western part of the United States. 76% of geothermal energy is used in California.
Now let's talk about how we made this amazing project.
We used pipe cleaners and bottle magic.
We tried using recyclable products like
plastic, wire, cardboard, and more.
We used two different boxes. One was big and one was small.
The big one is resembling a geothermal energy plant, and the small one resembles the Earth and its core.
The core pops out because that is where geothermal energy comes from.
Now let's focus on geothermal energy itself. We don't focus on using geothermal energy because we have all those other energy resources.
We should focus on geothermal energy because it's consistently reliable. It is a renewable resource and a pollution-free resource.
Bonus fact, the toxic fumes smell like rotten eggs.
It took us a long time as working as a team and finished this project.
We are very proud of our masterpiece.
Thank you for listening and focusing on our geothermal energy project. It was super fun. Thank you.
Have a great day.
Izzy and I are
the Wind Gang.
5 weeks ago, we started with the lump of clay. Over that period of time, we got to learn about different types of clay. We researched long and hard. Our item is the wind turbine.
The purpose of a wind turbine is to use the wind on Earth to create electricity for homes and businesses. The wind turbine turns a propeller, which turns in an electromagnetic field to create electricity, which could be used now or stored in batteries for later.
Every day is ways that wind turbines conserve and reduce our carbon footprint is that this source of renewable energy keeps the air and water clean without destroying our natural resources. You see that big blue fireball in the sky called our sun? It shines down, warming our waters.
You mean like how our parents and teachers shine down on us, warming our hearts?
Aw, Izzy, you sound like a poet and you don't even know it.
Nope.
Wind turbines are a very clean and sustainable source of energy. They are not the most efficient at this time, nor the most attractive, and they may be harmful to bats and seabirds, but they are a major step in the right direction for sustainable energy.
No, our project is simulated turbine with batteries powering the blades. A real turbine powered would be just the opposite with a wind turbine, with the wind creating the electricity to be stored in batteries.
Wind turbines take up a lot of space, which means less plants such as trees. The electricity produced by wind turbines is more expensive than non-sustainable energy sources. In the future, we hope the cost differential will go down with new technology. Interesting factoid, 42% of Denmark's electricity comes from wind turbines.
The impact on humans with wind turbines are wind turbines generate electricity for homes and businesses. So you can have light and much, much more.
For those interested, we have created information sheets on wind turbines. We have copies for each of you. If you want one, see me after the show.
Thank you for watching our presentation and be an energy saver.
My name is Henry Keeney, and we are the Fossil Friends.
We made an art piece to represent how fossil fuels are used. Our non-renewable resource is fossil fuels. Fossil fuels are made by dead plants and animals from millions of years ago. For our project, we decided to make an oil digger.
An oil digger is something that digs oil. It goes so far down into the ground that it pulls up that oil from the crust of the earth.
We all use this oil that it digs up. We use it by driving cars and electricity, and many other things too.
Maggie, let's tell them what fossil fuels are.
Well, fossil fuels are essentially the remains of plants and animals. They provide us with a source of non-renewable energy. Fossil fuels can come in the form of oil, coal, and natural gas. They are the result of the decomposition of a dead plant and animal matter buried deep in the Earth's crust. These fossil fuels are then pumped from underground and used in a variety of ways.
Raise your hand if you want to know what we used to make this awesome project.
Okay, I would love to. Some things we used were a big box, wrapping paper to wrap our box, cotton balls, and orange and tan schmear clay to make the oil digger. Henry, tell them some more.
Some other things we used were wooden sticks, a little box, blue paint, yellow tissue paper, a hot glue gun, and white string.
Guess what? Fossil fuels are the most used non-renewable energy in the world.
Geologists say that they produce large amounts of energy that is very accessible, is very easy to transport, and is a low cost.
Some negatives are that fossil fuels are being used at a higher rate, which means that they will soon run out and we'll have to rely on other things. It also emits pollution, which is bad.
I hope you like our project.
Thank you for coming and have a great day.
And we're the Super Nuclear Group, and we're here to talk about nuclear energy.
Hi, I am George Straub. This is our project. We have used many materials, including model magic paint and trees.
Hi, I'm Zoe Cooper. We have made a project about nuclear energy, and now we're here to tell you about it.
The energy source that we have chosen is a nuclear turbine because it is a type of nuclear energy. A nuclear turbine works by producing steam that makes energy. Nuclear turbines do take up space, but they produce lots of energy for the world to use.
Nuclear energy does not harm our Earth because the steam that comes out of nuclear turbine is non-polluted air. This has a very low effect on a lot of things, including Earth, people, and animals. This is amazing because nuclear energy can be used in many ways.
I bet a lot of you energy users are wondering about how the nuclear turbine makes steam to produce energy. Here is how it works. There is an atom called neutron that forms into a bigger atom called uranium, well, inside the nuclear turbine. Uranium is a big part of the nuclear turbine, but the one problem is uranium is very rare and only found in some countries. Uranium is a mined resource. That means you have to mine to get it.
Wow, Zoe, we should get back to how steam forms inside the nuclear turbine. So yeah, we start with a neutron that forms inside uranium, then it splits.
It splits like a piece of paper.
Yes, Taylor, but it splits like a piece of paper. But the cool thing is, it splits again and again into little pieces.
So now I hope you have a visual of the atoms inside the nuclear turbine. Splits like that, again and again and again, to produce steam. Not everything is good about nuclear turbine. It probably sounds like a success. One of the negatives is that sometimes nuclear accidents can occur, which is never good to human or animal life. There are now 437 nuclear turbines in the world. People better keep them safe or we could have a lot of accidents.
Taylor did some amazing research on the pros. One is that technology is not ready for market, as we can now use them in the world, not just in a few countries, including France, Hungary, Slovakia, and Ukraine, are the only countries that are known for having them.
I have a little bit of both negatives and positives. One big problem is the nuclear turbines are a non-renewable resource. So when we run out, well, that's too bad, because this is because of their uranium is rare. But a pro, yes, something good, the cost to make the nuclear turbine work is very low, as to produce steam.
Radioactive waste is a huge, huge, huge negative. Once the nuclear turbine is running for 3 years, the fuels are transported into a storage pool for at least 5 years, or it can go into in 450.
Wow, that's a long time. What happens after that, Taylor?
The process keeps going, as in the next step is you have to put it into considerate concrete boxes. They have to stay in these for a long time.
Like a million years?
Correct.
Nuclear energy is
very important. More and more people will soon notice that.
Now you see why nuclear energy is a useful energy source.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming to our presentation. I hope you learned something from our project. There are pamphlets outside. On your way out, you may take one.
Project. For our model, we did a hydroelectric dam. The clay materials that we used were blue model magic clay and gray model magic clay.
Hi, my name is Sam. For our big materials, we used a piece of cardboard for a pipe, a small toilet paper roll, smear clay for the river on the bottom, and a weight for the pipe holder.
Hi, my name is Mariel. For our project, we decided to use recyclable resources. For our small materials, we used a cardboard box which we cut, a small see-through paper, and blue paper on the bottom.
This energy source is challenging because fish and other organisms can be killed or injured by the turbine blades on the dam, so it is dangerous for the fish in the river.
If you are wondering what hydroelectric dams are, they are a mechanical energy of how moving water is moved by a rotating turbine to a generator.
The impact of hydroelectric dams are very positive because it doesn't pollute water and it can control a lot of small and big floods.
On the other hand, unfortunately, large dams have forced 40 to 80 million people from their land in the past 6 decades so that these dams can be built. While that is great for our planet, it was hard for the people who lost their homes.
You can find very famous hydroelectric dams all over the world, such as the Hoover Dam in the USA, Niagara Falls in Canada, and the Three Georges in China.
As you can see, there are many hydroelectric dams all over the Earth.
You see, hydroelectric dams are able to store water in a reservoir that is created when water is released through its turbines. The spinning of the water through the turbines activates a generator, and voila, electricity is produced.
The way this dam works is by the first pipe transferring water, then going through the second pipe, then it goes up with the water and shoots up water into the river.
Thank you for coming to our hydroelectric dam project. Have a nice day.
Hello, my name is Genevieve Skira, and we are the
Super Sunny Solar Solution Squad.
And we are here to talk about solar energy.
Hi, my name is Alana McDonough. The project that we made is a solar-powered boat.
Hello, my name is Tyler Hayes. The boat that we made runs off of solar power. Solar power is an energy that comes from the sun.
We will be telling you about how we made our boat.
This project was very hard to make. We had some challenges down the road, and I will tell you one. First, we put chalk underneath the cut because the model magic breaks if it's too thick.
By the way, did you know that there is a solar power airplane that just landed at 9:45 last night in Pennsylvania? And today they're going to New York and passing over the Statue of Liberty.
First, we cut out cardboard in the shape of a boat, then hot glued it together. Then we mixed black and white model magic to make gray and covered the boat. The clay cracked and we had to cover it up with black smeared clay.
Let's move on to the bathroom. For the sunset and the water, we put chalk underneath them and then put blue model magic for the water, red and orange model magic for the sunset, and yellow smeared clay for the sun.
Now we're going to talk about the pros and cons. The pros are that it's a clean energy source, and it is low maintenance, and it's renewable.
The cons of solar energy are it is expensive, intermediate, energy storage is expensive, it is associated with pollution, it uses exotic materials, and requires space.
Solar energy is both negative and positive, as you can see.
Now we're going to talk a little bit about the effect solar energy has on the environment. The effect that solar energy has on the environment is that it can create habitat loss for the animals.
Now, two bonus facts. Do you know that the solar panel is green? It is certainly greener than conventional ways of harnessing energy sources such as fossil fuel and coal. The second one is there are 496,805 square kilometers of solar panels for lighting up the entire planet with renewable energy.
I hope you now know about solar energy. Thank you for coming and taking time out of your day.
Now try to sing Super Sunny Solar Solution Squad 5 times fast.
Do you have any idea what they've been studying yet? It's my great honor and pleasure to introduce another fabulous teaching artist who has been coming in. Ronnie Gerstel is a visual artist, and she does a million different things with the kids. And this time, she's been making shadow puppets. So here's Ms. Gerstel.
Thank you so much. All right. Well, what our project has been to do public service announcements, short educational pieces about the topics that the kids chose. And our first group is on the topic of pollution, starring Flora, Talia, and Gracie. So, are you guys set? Let's turn this on so we have power. Enjoy.
Plastic pollution is being found in fish that are sold in fish markets. Did you know that 90% of seagulls have plastic in their guts? The fish and birds are eating plastic and that can cause harm to them. And look at all these straws found in the ocean. 5 million straws end up in the ocean and 5 trillion pieces of plastic are floating in the ocean every day.
I did not know that.
Have you ever heard of the Great Pacific Garbage Patch?
No, I haven't.
Well, the Great Pacific Garbage Patch is located in the North Pacific Ocean, and it's bigger than Hawaii. It was discovered in 1988 and started in Japan. The size of Trash Island is 270,000 square miles. That's bigger than Texas, too.
Well, thanks for letting me know.
Solve all these problems one way is by recycling plastic and aluminum, and don't litter. It can really affect the sea animals who get sick eating it and get tangled in the garbage. You should think about the sea critters in this ocean.
That's so cool. I'm glad I can help make a difference.
Well, I will do that next time. So the fish market man and the boy never left garbage in the ocean or beach again. And they hope you won't either. The end. Thanks for watching by Gracie Greaton, Talia Miller, and Flora Nagy.
Global warming is threatening our Earth. If we keep producing... If we keep producing carbon dioxide, there'll be more greenhouse gas, which causes global warming. Pollution gets trapped around the Earth's atmosphere and heats it up. That means more glaciers melting and sea levels rising. And if we don't stop, Miami, Florida, and other coastal cities could be underwater in this century, according to the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change.
One way to stop greenhouse gas is stop cutting down trees and plant more. Trees take in the excess carbon dioxide, which contributes the most gas in the greenhouse effect, and the trees produce oxygen for us to breathe. Another way is to use fluorescent light bulbs and energy-efficient appliances, and to reduce waste in landfills, which produce methane and other greenhouse gases. Another way to stop greenhouse gases is to use clean energy, like electric cars. It is very important that we all go green to reduce global warming. Will you help? The End, by Matthew and Shane.
Resources. On the non-renewable side, we have fossil fuels like oil, natural gas, coal, and nuclear energy. Non-renewable resources means that they cannot be removed quickly and will run out. On the renewable side, we have wind power, hydropower, solar power, geothermal energy, and biofuel. Renewable resources means that they can be replaced quickly and won't run out if we use them carefully.
Papa A is sitting watching football on his plasma screen TV.
Why can't we use more renewable energy resources to run our house? And why can't you watch less TV?
You know we can't afford that. Let's just stick to what we have.
I know it's expensive, but there's a greenhouse cloud that surrounds the Earth and traps sun rays, causing the temperatures to rise and glaciers to meet. And pretty soon, every city along the coast will be underwater. A few hours later,
I guess you're right, Sally. We should do our best to switch to use renewable and renewable resources for energy. It's worth the cost if it means saving our cities and maybe even the Earth.
Papa A's family started to replace things in their home that use non-renewable resources like the lamp, and they sold their things at a garage sale. They switched the solar panels on the roof for electricity to run the lights in his favorite, the plasma TV. Sooner or later, everyone will have to switch to renewable resources to stop cities and the coastline from sinking. When Sally grew into an adult, she got a job convincing people to install wind turbines, another renewable energy source, all around the world.
Bye!
So, can I have that lamp now?
Yeah.
Darn.
Bye!
Okay, fine.
students all brainstormed a whole bunch of concerns that we have about natural resources and renewable versus non-renewable energy. And we made a list, and then each group chose the one, the topic they wanted to tackle. The next part of our process was creating the PSA scripts, and then they created all the puppets, backgrounds, came up with the special effects. Then we rehearsed, and here we are now. And this next group, while they're setting up, is Sustainable Hunting by Christian, Julian, and Cade.
Eek, a hunter, I gotta hide. Am I safe yet?
We should be safe, little boy. My species used to be hunted excessively before a worldwide ban of whaling was put into place in 1973, but illegal hunting of my species still goes on.
Vroom, vroom.
Oh no, oh no. Here are the whalers.
I never let an animal get away.
I bet I'll be safe in here.
Are you a hunter?
No, Mr. Bat, I'm not a hunter.
Good, I'm a flying fox bat. Man hunts me for medicine, food, and just for sport. Recovery centers have recognized my species, but I can't find one to come home to.
Stop running!
Approximately 3.9 million trees are cut down every day. That's 1,051,200,000 trees destroyed every year. This means that we will end up without our homes.
This is the end, little boy.
How dare you try to shoot a majestic animal like me and then end up smiling in a picture next to me? We all need to start protecting our marine resources and animals. We need to stop overhunting and overharvesting. If we don't become more responsible, certain animals will become extinct.
Why is my home shrinking? Because people are wasting too much water.
The
they'd better stop because this is my home and it has everything I need to survive. People need to conserve water.
Do you have any ideas for me and my friend how to do that?
Well, if you're taking a shower, don't waste the cold water while waiting for it to warm up. You can collect it for your plants.
Saving water also saves energy.
Here's another way to conserve water. Turn off the water while brushing your teeth.
Another idea.
Fill your sink with water to wash all your vegetables.
In the United States, every day in the United States, we use about 110 million gallons of water. Now you know some ways to stop wasting water.
Thank you for conserving water. Now my home is safe and my population can grow bigger.
The bird is taking a walk in the forest. He notices that all around him the trees are getting cut down and falling over. Men are cutting down the trees for paper and wood. The bird leaves the forest and tells the other animals of the forest about the trees getting cut down. The animals have to flee the forest and leave. They wonder where they will go now and start deciding about and start wondering about what they will do. They decide to go around and tell the people about the importance of the three R's: reducing, reusing, and recycling. The animals walk up to a woman throwing a newspaper in the trash.
Hey, you humans are wasting so much paper, and paper is made from the trees where we live. Don't you know that you can help save the environment by reducing the amount of paper and other natural resources that you use?
The animals keep walking and see a man throwing a plastic water bottle in the trash.
The animals keep walking. You can recycle that plastic bottle. Don't throw it away. We can help cut down the landfills by recycling it in the blue bins.
You can help the environment by reducing the amount of garbage you make. By reusing things instead of throwing them out, and by recycling what you can. The landfill starts to get lower and shrink down. Hooray! The landfill is shrinking. You can help save the environment by reducing, reusing, and recycling.
All right, let's hear for all of our shadow puppeteers.